Once again, welcome to English Literature Classroom. Today I am going to teach Merchant of Venice, Act 1, Scene 1. And this is for Class 8, 9 as well as Class 10. Because all these three classes are studying Merchant of Venice and everyone has to watch this video. But it's mainly I have made for Class 8 because you all are beginner. Okay, so I have started from Act 1, Scene 1. In my last videos, I taught you up to line 105, okay? And in this video, I will continue after that. Now, look, the play starts with Antonio, okay? And Antonio was sad. Salarino, they were guessing out and finding out Antonio's sadness. Then Lorenzo, Bassanio, Gratiano come. Gratiano feel very bad when Gratiano looks at Antonio's face and Gratiano comments about that. Antonio tells that this world is a stage and he is playing a sad role. At that point of the time, Gratiano tells that he wants to play the role of a fool. And then he gives many more advices, okay, to Antonio. Now, I am starting from line number 105. Okay, Lorenzo is studying. Well, we will leave you till dinner time. After Gratiano has finished giving the advices, Lorenzo is telling that they want to leave him. I must be one of the same dumb wise men, for Gratiano never lets me speak. Okay, look what Lorenzo is telling. I want to be that same one wise man. Okay, what he is telling? I must be one of those same dumb wise men, for Gratiano never lets me speak. Lorenzo is telling that I will become a dumb man. Okay, I will become dumb. Why? Because I stay with Gratiano and Gratiano is so talkative that he doesn't allow me to speak. After that, Antonio is telling that, farewell, I will grow a talker for this year. Now look what Antonio is telling, that he has to become little bit talkative. Okay. Now Gratiano. Look what Gratiano is telling. Thanks, faith, for silence is only commendable for needs tongue dried. Means silence is not commendable for you. Okay, it is especially in a dried ox tongue. Okay, and now Antonio is telling, is there anything of concern? Okay, is that anything now? Means he's asking about Gratiano, that whatever speech Gratiano is giving, is it very important speech? He's asking to Bassanio. Look what Bassanio is telling. Gratiano speaks an infinite deal of nothing more than any man in all Venice. Okay, this Bassanio is telling, okay, Gratiano speaks an infinite deal of nothing. Means Gratiano speaks rubbish. Okay, Bassanio is telling that Gratiano speaks rubbish. Okay, then any man in Venice. Means in whole Venice, Gratiano is the only man who speaks rubbish. The sense in Gratiano's talk is hardly equal to 2 grains of wheat which lie hidden in a large quantity of chaff. Okay, large quantity of chaff. Chaff, it is a Hindi word of bhusa. Okay, and in large quantity of chaff, if 2 grains are hidden, what will happen? Will you be able to find it? No. And when you will find it, it will see that it doesn't have any value. In the same way, Gratiano's speech does not have any value. Okay, he has given a long speech, but it doesn't have any value. After that, Antonio is telling that, well, tell me, what lady is the same to whom you swore a secret pilgrimage that you told today, promised to tell me of? Okay, now Antonio is telling to Bassanio that, well, tell me now, which is the lady to whom you are promised to make a secret visit? Okay, now Antonio knows that Bassanio is going to visit any lady. Okay, now who is that lady? Antonio wants to know. Antonio is asking Bassanio, now tell me the name of that lady. Okay, look at this paragraph. Okay, well, tell me the name of the lady to whom you are promised to make a secret visit. You had promised to tell me about her today. Okay, Antonio is telling to Bassanio that you had promised me that you will tell about that lady today. Now Bassanio is telling, it's not unknown to you, Antonio. Look what Bassanio is telling. It's not unknown to you, Antonio, how much I have disabled mine estate. How much I have disabled mine estate means I have finished all my property. Okay, he's telling that, Bassanio is telling to Antonio that I have greatly wasted my wealth or property. Look, once Bassanio was a very rich man. He had a lot of property. Okay, but he had wasted all his property. Therefore, he's telling that, you know, Antonio, that I have greatly wasted my wealth or property by maintaining a somewhat higher standard of living. living. And how he has spent wasted all his property? By maintaining a higher standard of living. No, but he's telling that now I don't feel sorry about it. But my main worry is now to be honorably free from the great debts in which I have been involved. Now, what is Bassanio's concern now? To become free from the debt, okay? As he has finished all his money, now he is in debt. Okay, now his concern is to get out of the time, get out of the debt. Okay, now look, he is telling, wherein my time something to prodigal hath left me guest to you, Antonio. And he is also telling that, Antonio, I am mostly indebted to you in money and love, for you have given me both. Okay, and from love, I have a warranty. Look, he's telling, I owe the most in money and love, and for your love, I'll have a warranty to unburden all my plots and purpose, how to get clear of all the debts I owe. Now he's telling that, for you love me, and this love, you love me means Bassanio is telling to Antonio that you love me, okay? And this love gives me the right or permission to disclose to you all my plan. And as you love me, I can disclose all my plan to you, okay? And purpose for getting clear of these rights. Up to this much. And in my next video, again, I have to continue with the same Act 1, Scene 1. You have to read it, listen. Students, read it, very carefully read it. And when you are reading Merchant of Venice, by the side you will see all the meanings are given. You have to see the meanings, okay? Unless and until you see the meanings, you will not be able to get it. Okay, it's not so easy. You have to read it again and again. Obviously, after reading again and again, you will be able to understand. Okay, till then, goodbye.